Hey guys, welcome back to the Product Manager channel, where we talk about product, technology, and how to build awesome software. In today's episode, we're going to talk about why is it so critical for the product manager to introduce technical depth effort in your roadmap. So if that sounds good to you, smash the like, if you subscribe to the channel if it's your first time, and let's jump right in. So first, what is technical depth? So a quick Google search gave you that Wikipedia page definition. And basically, it says that a technical depth is a concept in software development that reflects the implied cost of additional rework that is caused by choosing an easy solution now instead of using a better approach that will take longer. Wait, what? What does that mean, right? So if we take a look, I like this diagram here. I'm going to use that to kind of like illustrate what we're talking about here. So basically, if you build a new application from scratch, right, whether it's a web app, mobile app, whatever, is the very first feature that you're going to build. So here in green, this is the time that it will take you to build that new feature. There's no technical depth. So 100% of the time is going to be dedicated to build this feature. So most likely you will be able to create a lot of value very quickly for the first few features because everything is new. So you write the code, you don't have to worry about existing dependencies or you know code that is already there, existing files and so on. So you, as you see, you are building a lot of value very quickly in the first few features. But then as time goes, you see this red section that is starting to grow, right? This is the time where you're struggling with complexity and depth. Basically, the more feature you add, the more technical depth you introduce into your software. Okay, so if you still confused, I have one cool analogy that I like to use when I explain this concept. You know, think about it when you're cooking. You know, if you're cooking at home and you're trying to build an entire meal, you might, you know, you want to make a salad, you want to make a dish, maybe some chicken and some veggies, and then maybe you won't even make a dessert, right? Like you have friends over, you're trying to cook the whole thing, you know. So what's going to happen is, if you don't clean up as you go, you're going to reach a point where you get stuck. And bam, this is what the kitchen's going to look like. You're running out of space, you're running out of plates, and you cannot move forward. You cannot cook the next dish until you clean up your space. So think about it as the same concept in software development. You know, as you build features, you accumulate depth, or in this case mess, and if you don't clean up this mess as you go, you're gonna accumulate so much mess in your code base that you will not be able to move forward, or will become incrementally difficult and time consuming to build new features. So this is why it's so critical to pay off technical depth as you go in order to be sustainable in the future. When you look at a kitchen in a restaurant, in a professional restaurant, they might be serving 200 meals a day. They might have 20 people running around, but they always keep the space clean, which is what enabled them to have so much velocity in their cooking delivery, right? So this is kind of like the same thing. You know, you're building software. If you want to go fast, especially if you have a lot of people involved, you need to make sure you clean up after yourself. You need to make sure you follow the same process, the same pattern from a development standpoint, so that everybody can keep moving and not get stuck. So how do you do that? Well, the first thing you need to do is to be aware of this concept and make sure you prioritize enough time to be allocated for technical depth. in your iteration, in your roadmap. So, perhaps you have 80% of the time that's focused on building a new feature, and then you might allocate 20% just for the development team to pay off this technical debt, which will allow you to build more feature faster and with a sustainable pace on the long term. So that's very critical. And basically, how do the developer make sure that they don't introduce technical debt? So there's many different ways to do that. We need to make sure that they need to make sure they follow best practices, they have the same coding standard across the team, and so on. But one key concept that I want to just quickly touch on in this video is dry. Don't repeat yourself. And this is a concept for developers that are writing the code, which basically mean that you need to write the code once and then use it everywhere in the application. So basically, what happened is the first time you write a feature. So let's say you have a drop-down selection module that you're writing, right? You go on the app and you can click a drop-down. You have a few choice. So that specific module, it's the first time you're using this drop-down in your application. So you have to write it, from scratch. So you write the code, and it's working. It's great. But then a month later, you have another features on a different page in the application, and the product manager wants to introduce another drop down. So now, the quick and easy way to do it would be to just quickly copy paste the code and reuse that code into the new page to deliver quick value to the customer. The problem by doing that is that you duplicate the same code base in two different places in your application. And then, in 6 months from now, if the designer wants to make a change in a drop-down, maybe we want to change the color or change the way it looks, now you need to maintain two pieces of code in two different locations. So now if it's just two times, it's not a big deal, but think about it if you're using the same piece of code 10 times on every single page on your website, right? You don't want to be maintaining 10 different duplicated pieces of code manually. The way you want to do it is to create an object that will be used only one time with one source of truth, and then every single page will call this drop-down object, but it will be the same code written only one time. So in order to do that, when you introduce your second page, you need to refactor the first screen that you have implemented in order to make this drop-down modular and reusable. So this is just basically one of the concepts that helps developer keep the application clean by refactoring work that they've already did based on new coming features to optimize the overall efficiencies and maintainability of your code base. So if you're a product manager without strong technical skill, that's okay. Just make sure you talk to your technical lead and perhaps your software engineer to understand the complexity of the app and the health of the app and the volume of technical debt. That way you can have this trade-off conversation while building your roadmap and introduce new features while keeping capacity for technical debt. Rule of thumbs, a healthy balance is perhaps 80% for new feature, 20% for ongoing technical debt. That will give your team enough time to focus on maintaining the quality of the app, which will help you in the long term to keep a high quality application and a sustainable pace to continuously deliver new features quickly to your customer. So that's it. Thank you guys for listening. As always, I really appreciate your support. If you got some value out of this video, make sure you press the like, and I'll see you in the next video. All right, bye-bye.